Good morning, children. Welcome back to social class. We already in which lesson learned and festivals of India. In that part, we already discussed about we have three types of festivals. What are they? Religious festivals, harvest festivals, and national festivals. In the religious festival part, we have discussed about four types of festivals like Diwali, Christmas, and Eid and Guru Purab. Now we are going to discuss about our second types of festivals, which we are talking about the harvest festivals. So, what is a harvest? What is the meaning of harvest? Can anyone tell? So, many people in India worship nature and thank it for like its gifts. Gifts means what? The light, the daylight comes from sun and the water. The water comes from the rain. So, the people, most of the people believe that sun as a god and the rain also as a god. So, who will mostly depend on them? They will worship them as they God. And definitely we need these both things, though these both sun and water, right? Sun we need to get a light in the day and water, and the rain god we need to have a good rains. So definitely these are the gift from which we have from the nature. So it is our responsibility that we always must be thanked to our nature. So by on the name of thanksgiving to nature, in our India we celebrate harvest festivals. So let's see how many types of harvest festivals we have and how the people will celebrate these harvest festivals. Mainly the people who depends on the nature, that people will celebrate these harvest festivals mostly. So can anyone tell who are those people mostly dependent on the nature? Like everyone, we all are dependent on the nature only, but compared to us, most of the people who will depend on the nature? Now we are all educated and we are going to jobs and earning money and we are getting salary monthly every month. But there are some special people, because of them we are getting a food, and but they can't have monthly income. They will only have income in a year. Who are those people? Can anyone tell? Who work in the fields? Yes, farmers. Those are the people who are really dependent on the nature. What we need, what the farmers need, definitely they need water and sunlight to grow good crops. When the crop is perfect to sell in the market, what we call it as harvested crop. Harvested crop is nothing but having a good crop, perfectly ripe crop. So if any farmers have a good ripe crop which is ready to sell in the market, definitely the farmer will thank to the nature. Why we need to thank to the nature? Because we already learned in our past lessons that too much water or less water can harm the crop, harm the fields, right? To have a good crop, we need sunlight and water. If these two things are heavy or these two things are not at all, then we can't grow perfect crop. So that is the reason every farmer believes that the sun and water as their god, and they always pray to them to have a good crop. So in between they don't have to face any difficulties or problems because of the nature. If they have their good harvest, they will be thankful to the nature. So they will give their thanks on the name of these harvest festivals. Can anyone tell, can anyone know which are the harvest festivals which we also celebrated and which we will also get holidays in the month of January? Can anyone tell? Yes, Sankranti. Sankranti is a harvest festival, Nana, which is celebrated by many of us. But mostly, who will celebrate means mostly farmers will celebrate. It's a harvest festival. It's a nature festival where everyone must be thankful to the nature, right? So if the farmers are, because if the farmers are dependent on the nature, but we also dependent on the farmers. If there are no farmers, can we get a food? No. So if they are also thanksgiving to the nature, at the same time we will also thanks to the nature, because of them only we are getting the food. That's why we always must thankful to our nature. So we are talking about a harvest festival, and I already announced that we will celebrate Sankranti as our harvest festivals. But can anyone tell, only in our Telangana only we will celebrate this harvest festival on the name of Sankranti? Yes. Do we have any other names also? Yes, we can call Sankranti as a Pongal in Tamil Nadu. But the same thing there, and we also do. What is the same thing? That we thanks to our nature. These harvest festivals is the reason why we celebrate them, is to say thanks nature. Maybe the names are different, but the purpose and the tradition is same how we will celebrate. For example, you are a student in the school, but you are son or daughter to your parents. We will call with your name, and there they will call you as your pet name, like Bujji, Kanna, Nani, like that, Sonu, like that. So you have a pet name, but the person is same. Like that only, maybe the names of the festivals are different, but the tradition and the main purpose of the festival is only one thing, that is thanksgiving to the nature, right? So how we will give our thanks to the nature? Simple, like we will cook pongal on that day. How we will cook pongal on that day? That we will have an earthen vessel, and in that they will pour milk and they will add rice and jaggery, and they will cook pongal. Like in Tamil Nadu, people also do the same thing, but they will do the thing in the temples. On the name of the harvest festival, they will cook pongali. So that day, that particular delicious dishes we cook, delicious dish we cook, that call as pongali. So that is the name is derived to celebrate as a harvest festival, pongal. Pongal is a derived from a dish called pongali. So what they do, Tamil Nadu people will cook the an earthen vessel, like a pottery vessels are there, and a pottery vessel they will pour some milk in that, and after some time when the milk boil, they will add some jaggery and rice, and they will cook pongali. So that is the reason they will celebrate pongal. So that is the reason we call that festival as a pongal festival, because every family will cook pongali on that day. Why they will cook pongali on that day? Because they are giving thanks to the nature, because they will have a good harvest crop. That is the reason they want to thank the nature, like they want to thank the sun, and at the same time they want to thank the rain god also. And in other state we will celebrate as in Assam. If we take in Assam, we will celebrate as Bihu. Bihu is also known as a harvest festival. Like the people, how we will cook pongali here, how the Tamil Nadu people cook pongal, like that only Assam people celebrate the harvest festival, but the name is different. We call it as Bihu festival. What is the name of the festival in Assam? Bihu festival. And we have two types of Bihu festivals, like Rangali Bihu and Pongali Bihu, and that is also celebrated in the month of January. Here the month is same, Nana. If we take Tamil Nadu, we call it as Pongal festival, and in the month of January we will celebrate. If we take Assam, we will call it as Bihu, and in the month of April, and I told you that we have two types of Bihu festivals, like Rangali Bihu and Pongal Bihu. So here we have April and January. These 2 months they will celebrate, right? So how the Assam people will celebrate? Here in Tamil Nadu we will cook pongal, but Assam people will gift a cloth called ghamosa, not samosa, right? But we call it as ghamosa, G-A-M-O-S-A, ghamosa, which is a cloth where it is a white color cloth which we have red color lines on it. It is a traditional cloth for them. So they will gift each other, and they will dance. They will dance because they have a good crop. That festival is celebrated by who? Assamese. That festival is celebrated by Assamese in Assam. Which kind of festival is that? Religious festival is a harvest festival. It is a harvest festival. But here we cook pongal, but there they don't cook pongal. What they do? They gift a cloth which is called as ghamosa to each other, and they will do their traditional dance. So we are talking about which festivals here? We are talking about a harvest festival. What is a harvest festival? On the name of thanksgiving to nature gods, if we celebrate any festival, we call it as a harvest festival. Do we have a harvest festivals in our Andhra Pradesh and Telangana? Yes, we have. Like Ugadi is also a harvest festival. It's a spring season festival. And in other state, if we take Punjab also, they will also celebrate a harvest festival. It is called as Baisakhi. Okay, that is also like a pongal, comes in a month of January only. That is also for them is a harvest festival. Okay, so now we are talking about a pongal festival, which is a famous in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. In Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, this pongal festival is used to call as Sankranti. Sankranti. Sankranti is a big festival for farmers because they do much hard work in fields to get good harvested crop. If they get good harvest crop, definitely they have a right to enjoy on the name of the festival. So this Pongal is celebrated by Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh Telangana people. How they will celebrate? By cooking a pongali. So by cooking a pongali, how we will cook pongali? Like adding milk, jaggery and rice in a pottery item. We will first, the first ripe harvest crop which we get from the crops, that will be first offered to God. Then only we will eat it. So that is a tradition which is coming from the for generations, and now we are following now from past generations now which we are following now also. So these are the harvest festivals which we have, and what are those harvest festivals? Like Pongal and Bihu, which is celebrated in Assam. Maybe the tradition, the names are different, but that what is the common thing in here? We have that Bihu and Pongali, these both are harvest festivals. What kind of festivals? These are harvest festivals. Maybe in Assam people won't cook any Pongal, but they will also give their thanks in their own way. Like they are gifting ghamosa cloth to each other, and in Tamil Nadu they will cook Pongal and they will offer this Pongal to Sun God. Why they are offering this Pongal to Sun God? Because they believe that sun and the rain, they both are gods for them. If they are not helping them, they can't have the crop perfectly. If they can't have good crop, they can't have good money. So money is very important for everyone. So that is the reason we have to thank to the nature. So on the name of thanksgiving to nature, if we celebrate any festival, we call it as a harvest festival. So everyone open your volume, page number 12. Yes, volume 2, page number 12, and lesson we are in S3, harvest festivals, right? So what is the first question here we have? Look at the picture and write the names of the festivals in the box given below. So first thing, you have to write the date. Don't forget to write the date, Nana. So by looking the picture, which festival we can say it? Now only I told that in an earthen vessel we will cook a one pongali, call it as which festival? It is a, you know, answer, and it is, you know, answer very well. So complete the box. Who celebrate this? Bihu is celebrated by whom? Assamese. And Pongal is Tamil Nadu people. When are they celebrated? In the month of January. And here I already wrote on the answer on the board also. So write one way in which these are celebrated. How Bihu is celebrated on, how Pongal is celebrated, I already told, and you know the answer very well. So what is common between Pongal and Bihu here? What is the common in these two festivals? What is the common thing we have in these two festivals? Which kind of a festival these? Pongal and Bihu, religious festivals, national festivals? No, no. So what is the common thing in here? What kind of festival it is? Yes, you know the answer. Just write answer and send your volume in WhatsApp. I hope you understood the lesson. Thank you.